Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. We're doing something a little bit different. I'm Trent.
I'm Ken Hartman.
And happy St. Patrick's Day to everybody watching.
Well, you know, it's St. Patrick's Day for them, not for us, because we're actually recording this in the past and they're in the future, folks. So it's St. Patrick's Day for the future, but not for us, because we're recording for them, which they're in the future and we're in the past. So.
I was having trouble with that. But hey, we're doing something a little bit different today, as I previously stated. We're doing a little cooking video. This is all John's idea. In fact, he came up with a lot of great ideas that we're going to do for St. Patrick's Day and for Star Wars Week coming up.
For May the 4th.
May the 4th. So John, would you like to take the honors of explaining what we're doing to the
audience? Sure. So basically, like he said, we are doing some cooking today. And what we are going to be doing is we are going to make some Irish nachos. And we are going to try to make our own shamrock shake. So, yeah, that's what we're going to be doing today. It's a little different from our usual stuff, but we're like, hey, we should do something for St. Patrick's Day. And this is the first thing I thought of. So, that's what we get today.
Yep, so, in order to make Wilson Club Entertainment's very fine, very unique, very Jonathan Irish nachos, if we ever come up with a cookbook, we can put that up at the top of the banner. We have some waffle fries, or best choice waffle cut french fried potatoes. One of the last few bags at the store, which almost made me call the store everything but waffle fries.
I think that actually was the last bag at the store.
Yeah. I want a name brand, but they only have generic. You're also going to need a whole slab of bacon. This was the cheapest bacon they had, because I wasn't about to spend $14 on bacon. It kind of looks like the Hidden Valley logo a little bit.
Yeah.
And we also need some cheap, wow. I was hoping it would like fall out of the flop, but just we also need some, cut that part out. We also got some cheese, we got mild and sharp cheddar, just giving us a little bit of variety, guys. A little bit of mixing.
Okay.
See, the daddy cheese and the mommy cheese love each other.
Okay.
So we're gonna get started on those Irish nachos, first thing. Before we do that, if you guys enjoy this content, let us know down in the comments below. We'll make a lot more cooking videos like this, because we do have a lot more planned in the future. Make sure to, you know, leave some stuff in the comments, like this video, share it, do all the YouTube rigmarole. So, without further ado, let's get cooking. Alright, so first thing we gotta do, we gotta preheat this toaster oven. We were gonna use the actual oven, but we'll just use the toaster oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. And are we doing the full bag or half bag?
Full.
All right, we'll do full, which is about 18 to 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna have to do a lot of editing for time.
Yep.
So now we wait. We'll see you all in 2030.
Oh, wait on.
Do you wanna calm down there? There's a rip in the paper. Oh, shoot. This is why we don't record when putting fries on the thing. All right, so in for about 18 to 20 minutes.
Wait, now we're getting the bacon on there.
Yeah. Bring on the bacon. How many strips? It's a small pan.
Yeah, I would say like four at a time. Four or five at a time. Nice, wait.
Kids don't try this at home.
Don't try this at home. Yeah,
we're
warning
you. We're trained professionals.
We're trained.
I'm using the stove because I'm a big boy. John got to use the toaster oven. He got to use the oven mitts to put the fries in.
Wow.
What?
Outing me like that.
That's what friends do.
Yep. Alright, so he's just gonna put the bacon on and then we will come right back when it's all cooked.
Look at that. Got some crispiness to it.
Talk like an actual cooking show.
Yeah. That is where all the flavor is right there. Yeah. I think it's shirtless and cooking. Disclaimer, I'm not the best cookie bacon. I probably should have said that before I started cooking bacon.
Oh, you love when I flip you, baby, huh?
Oh, yeah, I know you love when I flip you. I love you.
I love you, too.
Right to my Pepsi.
There we go.
All right, so we're cooling off the bacon now. And while we do that, we're going to twist John's nipple with the hot
cream. Whoa. Crispy. Almost as crispy as Anakin Skywalker.
Ooh.
were the chosen one! It was said that you would destroy the Sith, not join them! Bring balance to the Force, not leave it in darkness!
Back in the toaster oven for a few minutes. We're gonna put some cheese on those boys melt. Time for the money shot. Fries are finishing up. We're gonna do our Shamrock Shake. There's literally no science to this whatsoever. Probably the easiest thing in here.
Oh, extra packaging.
Well, look at that. It is like toothpaste green right there. It's like Nickelodeon slime. It's almost neon. Scoop it. You want me the big spoon? I'll be the little spoon.
Two scoops.
That was more like 2.5 at how big that last scoop was. Alright, there we go. Now it's like 3. Then that's correct.
I will. What?
He's threatening this movie.
Let's see. That's better.
Yep, totally.
Probably add like one more scoop.
Another scoop?
Another scoop.
You're getting crazy with this.
It has to be thick.
Thick boy. 2 C's and a Q. Don't know where the Q factor is in, but...
It's in there somewhere. Yeah.
Q for... Quap. I don't know. Quap.
Oh, listen.
Good thing we're doing this in your kitchen. That's everywhere. Chug. Look at that throat. Attractive. Ladies, he is open.
Look, it's Saint Patrick. Lovely weather we're having.
You're so funny, you know that? You're a comedic genius.
Holy moly.
That looks like a heart attack.
Yep. Quadruple bypass. I don't even know what a bypass is.
We got some B-A-C-O-N ASMR.
Oh.
You can tell I almost burnt the bacon.
Almost. I almost did it, but I didn't.
This piece says otherwise.
Walker. Oh. I mean,
We could totally cook. We swear, we could cook.
Yeah. Well, I mean, John was like, oh, you go.
No wonder it's not cooking. I'm trying to do a John impression. I gotta get my voice nasally.
Wow.
No wonder it's not.
No wonder it's not cooking, it's on low.
Why do I sound like SpongeBob now?
No wonder it's not cooking, you put it on low. I'm like, well, John, the bacon's gonna burn if you don't keep a close eye on it. And even though it's keeping a close eye on it, it's still kind of got a little crispy.
Really sell the authenticity of the Shamrock Shake. John and I, we shoplifted these, the cafe cups.
Oh, it's really chunky. Come on, pull yourself together.
Bum bum ba-dum, bum ba-dum. Why are you doing that? Look at that.
I don't know, first song came live. Look at that. We got our shamrock shakes. We got these delicious Irish nachos. Bon appetit. Grab us some forks, please.
Yep.
This is my shake. This is John's shake. Look at that. Freaking.
No wonder this is called cock bones on it. You're going to die from drinking that much milkshake all at once.
Yep.
Oh. All right. Taste test time. You ready?
Okay. Well, a little burnt, a little stringy, but it's fine.
Now we're mukbangers. Sitting in front of the camera.
There you go.
Yeah. Look at this. Huh. Oh.
Good?
Mm-hmm.
All right. My turn. Just dying a heat over there. Okay, look at that. If I can, you know, keep it from falling. Very good.
It's good.
All right, now ready for challenge number three.
No. I'm not doing any more food challenges.
Whoever finishes this gets the eggnog.
Thanks. The shakes and the fries are good. All of it together, just kind of. I was worried because the bacon was going to be burnt. But. Not burnt, just overcooked.
I know what I'm doing. I'd say this was a success.
I was just about to say the same thing.
Ooh, hot.
No. I don't know if we can eat all of this.
Uh-huh.
I don't know. But we want to thank you for joining us on this unique adventure. There's some exciting things planned. More cooking videos on the way if you enjoy this one. This is just really good, really. Like, the cheese is so chewy that it, like, kind of jumps
and
up.
And it's not, like, overly cheesy either.
Mm-hmm. Kudos again to Jonathan. He came up with this idea. We hope you guys have a happy St. Patrick's Day. Make sure we're green or else you're going to get pinched. But until then, I've been Trent.
I've been Kevin Fireman.
And, bon appetit. Alright. Fries, man. What is it called in the UK?
I'm leaving that in.